Welcome back to Friday Night Football number 38, sponsored by Rocket Mortgage. Zan here calling the action with Bugs, and this is semifinal number one of two. This is Drag versus Kmac. Kmac's a player that, you know, we've been accustomed to seeing him do well in Friday Night Football. Drag has kind of struggled in FNF. I mean, he had a slow 19, and just like that, Pollard, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Kmac on the board first. But Drag's kind of struggled a little bit in Friday Night Football. This is about as deep as we've seen him run.
Yeah. Drag has, he struggled to really put it together. He hasn't put together the run that he really wants to put together so far. But Drag is one of those players. He's a vet. He's been doing this for a long time. He knows how to play the game. He knows how to put together an offense. He's good at this. Like, he knows what he's doing. He's been around the block. So at some point, he's going to put it together. And that's what he's trying to do. He's trying to get it going right now in this tournament.
Again, semifinal number one of two. Next game coming up after this will be Rage versus Prodigy. So we've staggered these for two reasons. One, to give you guys more games to watch here on Friday Night Football every single week. And two, to allow both semifinal. Typically what's happened is if we run the semifinals simultaneously, one of them always ends sooner than the other. Then that winner gets to scout the last quarter or, you know, 6-7 minutes of the game. Kind of an unfair advantage. So now, in this situation, both players that are in the other semifinal game can watch, scout, then they play their game where the winner of the first semifinal game gets to turn around and get that equal opportunity.
Yeah, exactly. It gives these guys that break and also the scouting opportunity that they need in order to prepare themselves for that final game.
We appreciate everybody hanging out with us in the chat. AFC Canuck 5, one of the regulars coming in here every single week. Plenty more giveaways on deck for you guys. Again, you guys are watching here. The Friday Night Football Studio just built that this week. Appreciate you guys making this possible. Your support every week has allowed us to get out of that that sweat closet that that we were streaming in back in FNF 1. Oh, yeah. It's come a long way in 38 weeks.
No air, no AC in there whatsoever. And I mean, just think about it. We go back and look, we looked at that first Friday Night Football, that clip. And
do we still have that picture, Will?
And me being in the hoodie. Like, I didn't know what I was getting myself in. I didn't know I was going into a sweat closet. That's the one thing that Rockets did not tell me coming into it. He didn't tell me you may need to leave your hoodie at home. It was rough for your boy.
there it is.
And then they got a bad screenshot as well. It looks, I don't know what I was fixing to say. I was probably telling the people that it's time to take this hoodie off because I'm hot and ready to go. And your boy needed a haircut as well. But it's all good. My barber was out of town that week.
And now we're here. Look at us. Look at us. Who'd have thought? Not me. You know that meme, right?
No, I don't.
You haven't seen that meme yet?
No.
Okay. All right. Well, the chat knows. I'm sure somebody got it. Yeah, a couple people got what I was getting at right there. First down and 10 here for Drag. He's in this trips tight end offense. This is a formation that is synonymous with Drag. He loves these trips tight end style formations.
Oh, he scrolls through the hole and was able to walk into the end zone. Drag with a huge touchdown right there. About to tie the ball game up, barring a miss extra point or block kick. 7-7 ball game.
At Rocket Mortgage, we get that a home is more than a house. It's your escape, your fortress, your arena. So we'll be here when you need us, handling house so you can do home. Rocket Mortgage, official mortgage lender of Esports.
So the long run by Tony Pollard to get on the board for Kmac is answered by a run of Drag's own, 7-7 after one possession each. Now Kmac back on the attack offensively. Now this is kind of something that we talked about earlier, Boogs. You said that, let's say that you were going to run one of these heavier sets. Mm-hmm. You said yourself that you would always pass first out of these sets to set up your run. Kmac is known as a passer. So to see mm-hmm. him in a formation like this, he kind of takes that similar approach.
Yeah, I think that's the best approach for a formation like this, because when people are going to automatically respect the run when you come out in a formation like this. So they're going to set up run defense. And one of the best things you can do is take advantage of that run defense. And most people run defense is cover one defense, that cover one edge blitz, or cover zero. And those defenses aren't that good as far as the pass is concerned, they aren't going to hold up well if you just start to put out some really good dots, some corner routes and posts and different things like that. I mean, I saw one of the GOATs of Madden. If you don't know who this guy is, you should. Big Gene, I saw him in a chat earlier today as well. Show up, Philadelphia Eagles Club Series, playing W in the play-in game for the club. And he just straight up came out in Panther heavy and was dotting away. He really didn't run the ball that much until it was time to close the game out. And it kept W on his heels, and W couldn't really stop it. And that's exactly how I would approach it as well. Come out in a run heavy set like that and have some dots.
Couldn't have said it better myself. In fact, we've seen some decent Panther heavy offenses on this stream. But the one that Gene ran last night, it's not even close. That's the best we've seen heavy Panther in this community.
I honestly wish I can go back and find a clip from when this Panther heavy first came out, when it first got put on the scene in Madden 20. And when I said the way that I would run it is come out with dots and then run the ball. And that's exactly what Big Gene did. He's like I said, he's one of the GOATs. I know a lot of you guys know Problem Right for being the GOAT. Well, this was the GOAT before the GOAT.
Right.
And Gene was a dotter. He's one of those guys. He's opposite of what Problem was. Problem is more of a defensive guy, time management, stuff like that. Gene is an offensive guy. He's one of those guys that's known for putting together the schemes. And he showed it right there with just putting together something nice and crispy that was working very well and put together a great game. And we'll see him at the Philadelphia Live event.
So Kmac with the field goal on his second drive of the ball game. Now drag. Here's Tommy Bohannon. He's going to step out of bounds at the 26-yard line. 4:30 to go here in the first half. Winner moves on to our final matchup. $1,000 on the line. We saw our Blitz Cash Bounty, sponsored by Rocket Mortgage, redeemed by Tony Montagnino, a.k.a. VTech, in the first round with a victory over Joke. VTech made it to our final eight before bowing out to Drag, who just throws that ball out of bounds. VTech will be here next month. Black Friday, he'll be here right after Thanksgiving, casting with Nick. So we'll be bringing VTech in his, I think his agreement was if he was going to cast with us, he had to wear the all-orange Dumb and Dumber jumpsuit that he wore out to the Madden Classic.
Classic stuff right there. He wore it at the Madden Classic. And when I first looked at him, I'm like, yo, who is this clown over here in this outfit? I mean, I should have known.
Ooh, little
great stick right there.
Drag. You know, Grandpa Drag with a little stick work right there as Nick Chubb finds the end zone for a touchdown, and it's Drag on the board twice. Not through the air like we'd expect, but on the ground.
Yeah, I mean, Drag has, over the last few years, he's mixed in the run enough. He's not really a runner, but he will mix it in. He's shown the willingness to run the ball in this trips formation, whether it's trips tight end or just trio or whatever version of trips that he likes to run for the year. He's shown the willingness to run the ball and try to mix that in, or at least dumping the ball off in the flats to the running back.
That's Boogs. I'm Zan calling the action here. Semifinal number one of two here on Friday Night Football number 38. Behind us, if you guys are just tuning in, this is our brand new 15-foot LED board here in the Friday Night Football studio, Huntsville, Alabama. Really sick. I mean, this little board, I'm speechless. Every single time we come in here, I'm like, wow, we've come so far, and it's still only the beginning. You guys in the chat making this possible. I see some dice rolls in the emote. Let's go ahead and roll a giveaway. We'll get the graphic up here on the screen for you. Troy Polamalu. If you do not want the Troy Polamalu, you can instead choose the Peyton Manning plus the 92 Denzel Ward most feared, the 92, as we have an interception by Ty Law. Now Drag looking to build on that four-point lead. It'll be Manning, Denzel Ward, Travis Frederick, and I'm forgetting one more. So many items to give away. Who is it? Denzel Ward, Ndamukong Suh, and Travis Frederick, along with Manning. So you can get all four of those guys or the Troy Polamalu if you win the giveaway.
Sorry, I couldn't help you there. In my head, I'm thinking.
It's so many cards.
I want to say it, but I was like, I don't know. I really just left you out there on that island all by yourself.
That's all right. We figured it out. Is here once again. Here's Nick Chubb, 10-5. Drag is toting. Touchdown, and just like that, it's going to be a 21-10 ball game. So, K-Mac's got some work to do here. that run first. Well, it's not really a run first offense. It's that strong H-wing offense. Not as explosive as, say, his spread offense that he runs.
It's not as explosive at all. And it may be time to jump into that spread because the strong H-wing is not working right now. So find something else that's going to get you down the field, get you some quick points, and then come out and try to play some defense and get some defense. It looks like Drag is running base and not an inside zone.
Yeah, a little halfback base. That pulling guard has done very well for Drag, opening up those running lanes for Chubb. Now with the 28-yard line, Kmac will go to work. Last possession intercepted by Ty Law. One play later, Nick Chubb with a long touchdown run. He's going to go right back to that that strong H-wing formation. So
looks like we changed vantage points here.
Went to the higher quality stream here. So this will be which side are we watching from, Will? We're watching from Kmac's vantage point right now.
Also, I mean, I saw this. I paused my screen. I got NorCal Navy Mike said, what are some veggies that you don't like? He's talking to me, by the way.
he's like, Zan don't like veggies. Yeah. Look at him.
he said, we'd like to see some sort of betting between you and your co-hosts on whatever topic y'all are down for that doesn't involve you having to truly pollute yourself. Number one, shout out to Mike for caring about my body, caring about my temple. You guys want to set me up for these bets where I got to eat buckets of chicken and stuff.
Another real peppers with the interception.
Another huge interception right there. But, yeah, shout out to Mike for actually caring about my well-being, unlike the rest of you around here. I'm even going to include Will in this. Even though Will never really says anything about these bets, but I just feel like he should step in somehow and shut this stuff down as well. So shout out to Mike.
Hey, I just want to say that my lunch this afternoon was at the airport. I got one of those snack packs with celery, broccoli, and carrots.
Okay.
That was my lunch this afternoon. Trust me, that's probably as painful for me as eating a bucket of chicken is for you, Bugs.
But to answer your question, I hate mushrooms, despite the fact that I drink mushroom coffee. I hate mushrooms.
That's a fungus anyways.
I completely hate mushrooms. I don't really eat mushrooms at all. The mushrooms that I consume are medicinal mushrooms like chaga, you know, cordyceps, lion's mane, stuff like that. I don't really eat the mushrooms or whatever. And then another thing I don't like is okra.
Oh, see, I love okra. Is it texture, like the slime on it?
Yeah, because I went to culinary school. So because of that, we had to prepare an okra dish in class one day. And if you have to actually, have you ever prepared okra?
I have not.
Okay, prepare okra and then let me know how much you like it.
See, I like all the weird veggies. I'm like asparagus, Brussels sprouts. I like okra, collard greens. I love spinach. I don't like kale. I really don't like kale, but I do like spinach. We'll dot back over the middle to John Ross as Drag. After that Jabril Peppers interception, he's been surgical so far. I mean, playing good defense, running the ball, taking the short stuff. He's in real good spot right here. Our winner of our giveaway was It's Barraza with the sub. He's been subbed to the channel. He's been following since August 7th of this year. Appreciate that. And apparently It's Barraza, fun fact from Rockets, It's Barraza won the FIFA. We actually have Tuesday night football on Futhead TV. It's Barraza won a FIFA giveaway also this week. So the rolling giveaways for It's Barraza have been kind this way or this week. So congratulations. We still got plenty more on the way. More Troy Polamalu's, Mannings, Sue's, Ward's. It's first down and 10 here for Drag.
Mr. Twitch Taco, no, subs are not the only ones that can win giveaways. You do not have to be a sub. You just have to be following the channel. Subbing to the channel does not increase your chances of winning whatsoever. Just follow. Be a positive force for good. And also, you got to learn how to whisper sweet nothings into Nightbot's ear. You guys don't tag Nightbot enough and let Nightbot know how you really feel about her. And if you learn how to do that, I promise you, it's a recipe for success.
I see Lenyel in the chat says, I just tuned in, and the first thing I see is Boog's got the chat talking about Brussels sprouts. To be fair, I brought up Brussels sprouts, I believe. So I'll take that one, Lenyel. Boog Drag in full control right now. 43 seconds left in the first half, entering the red zone yet again. Ben Roethlisberger at the helm. This is a quarterback that a lot of players have been talking about this week. He gets that hot route master, kind of a sneaky play at the QB to get all those routes. Normally we were used to seeing Aikman or Rivers, but this Roethlisberger has gained a lot of popularity as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's cheaper for one. I think you can get him at 43 cap and have hot route master on him. That's a very cheap cap quarterback as far as a quarterback that also has the throw power. You can have him at 91 throw power as well. So he's a value guy. And honestly, he has a pretty good release as well. His release seems like it's pretty fast. You can get the ball out of your hands with him. Solid pickup.
I'll tell you what, it's a good thing that EA fixed this as drag puts that up and through. That field goal is going to make it a 14-point ball game. But Roethlisberger, when the game first dropped, was hands down the best quarterback in the game. Mm-hmm. His sleight of hand ability was ridiculous. You pump faked any coverage, it was a one-play score with the sleight of hand. That's how good Roethlisberger was to start the year, but they fixed that right away.
Yeah, I mean, that's good for the game that it was fixed versus, you know, having something like that on stream on a Friday night football or even, you know,
can you imagine
a bigger stage for $100,000? You got Big Ben out here pump faking and throwing easy buckets. I don't know if you necessarily want that on the game.
Checking out the chat here. The legends tonight were Gene Upshaw and Ty Law.
JM, what's good? How you doing, boss? Welcome to the stream. Appreciate you stopping by. Appreciate all of you guys for stopping by, kicking it with us, enjoying this Friday night with us, and just enjoying some football, man. Enjoying some virtual football, I should say, and some good conversation as well.
The Drunk Gamer OG says commercials are too long. I'm curious what commercials you're talking about, man. Are you talking about when you come into the stream? Second down and 7 here as we have trips tight end. Drag dominating this one as Roethlisberger going to barely get that ball out, chucks it away. Good decision making there by Drag.
Stranger, can you get some clarification on the fandom change from Lions to Falcons? You know, the Lions, you know, they're showing me that they don't care. Let me ask you this. Honestly, I don't want to say story time with books. It's time to have a conversation, Chad.
It's all right. I take a soapbox every now and then. Right. Have at it.
Let's say this. As we watch this dot to Shannon Sharp, Drag just dotting away, I might add. He's looking really good, moving the ball with ease, looking like he's about to move on to the next round. But back to this topic really quickly. Really quickly.
I'm curious to see where you're going with this.
So you're in a relationship, right, Zan? All right. You find out that this lady don't care about you. You know, she start packing your things and selling them off for no reason. She sells your favorite item, whatever your favorite gadget at home.
Okay.
Your favorite toy. She constantly cheats on you. She mistreats you. What do you do? Do you stick around and you take that abuse, or do you move on?
So you're saying the Lions are an abusive girlfriend?
She's abusing me, and enough is enough. Me too.
My man just said me too. It's all drag out here. When it's 21 points, Boogs gets on the soapbox and he tells you that he's done with the Lions. He'll be back on the if the
all
Lions win
aside,
this.
I love the Lions.
If they win this week, you're going to be all the way back on them next week. We already know you.
All jokes aside, I love the Lions. I'll never switch up on them, but they are mistreating me and my feelings are hurt.
Well, they can't be more hurt than mine right now, Boogs. I guess we didn't trade away a player that, you know, meant something to us at the time. And, you know, but it's rough out here on the offensive side of the ball. It makes me want to cry watching our defense play 37 minutes every single game and knowing that we don't have a first-round pick. It's all right. I like Khalil Mack. Don't get me wrong, but. Boy, we could use a first-round pick this year. Lord Vaco says you brought a tear to his eye.
Yeah, at the end of the day, it's honestly the things like the question about the trade. It's just things like that kind of just bothers me when you have a team that's just – they seem to –